I've always known that this shit was awesome, and it's something that I've kind of just turned into a business. I've turned my passion into a business, and I've had a lot of fortune in my life. I've had a lot of support in my life, so a lot of that has helped. But for those of you that don't have the same level of support, there's no excuse. You still got to push forward. The main thing is to follow through. People are a bunch of pussies out there. I'm going to give it to you straight right now. People are a bunch of fucking punks. People are a bunch of fucking pussies. And they don't follow through on shit. They don't follow through on any ideas that they have. They talk about their dreams and their passion before they go to bed. And they wake up the next day with those dreams and hopes deflated before they even drink their first fucking cup of milk. Don't be that pussy. Don't be that person. I do apologize for all the swearing, but this is a passionate thing for me to talk about this kind of stuff. Because all this really is you taking a concept and an idea and following through on it, no matter what anybody else says. Don't do a magazine. Don't do a whatever you do, don't do a printed magazine. Fuck you. I'm going to do a printed magazine. You know why? Because powerlifters need it. The only person that can really help yourself is yourself. Maybe you got a good wife in your corner, a good husband in your corner, or a good mom or good dad. They can come close, but no one's going to help you as much as yourself.
I started training people when I lived with my parents, training in a very small garage with extremely low ceilings. The ceilings were so low that a kid that was a basketball player would have to duck his head forward every time he deadlifted. We would train in the backyard using stones. We would train at these ghetto playgrounds, or I'd take them up to the woods near the water towers. When I finally bought a house with my fiance, I trained people out of that house for about 4 years. And we actually trained in the garage and in the backyard and at the local elementary school for a year before we even moved into the house. Guys that I was training, we would meet in the backyard and there was like raccoon shit. Cats were bringing birds and other dead animals and leaving them in the backyard. We trained all around that stuff. This is what I do. This is my commitment to working with athletes. And that's what you must have, a commitment to whoever it is that you want to work with. When you have that commitment, that drive, that heart, that passion, you will find a way. The energy will always be there. You know, sometimes I forget, I say, damn, I'm 37. Statistically, half my life, you know, they say is over. But I say it's only just beginning. I stay strong, I stay tough, I stay motivated and committed because I want to represent my family. I want to represent underground strength coaches all around the world. I want to represent and give hope to all those guys and girls that have a passion for the iron game and want to change the lives of others. And you think that you have to have some big fancy place. You have to have a high level of knowledge and you've got to have a big heart.
You know, whenever you're dealing with a competitive mindset and people who, I call it being locked in, people who get locked into a vision, all right, that's it, man. That's their drive. That's their passion. Critics don't matter. This don't matter. They're going to do whatever it fucking takes to be the best at what they do, okay? Most people in society will never understand that because they've never had passion about anything, okay? People who have had passion about things and worked their ass off for it will totally get it.